Hello, good people. Have you ever been in a situation where you're outside enjoying the nature, the beautiful flowers, the blue sky, the fresh trees, and just happen to have a hard drive with you that has a lot of important information that you don't want to get ruined by other elements in the nature like rain, dust, or potentially dropping it due to a slip and fall? Well, there is a product for you, which is what we're talking about today. So let's check it out, right after this.
Are you ready?
Okay.
Watch this.
Whew, so that is what the components must feel like inside the H500P Mesh by Cooler Master. Check it out in the description below. Whew. Now, one of our most popular storage videos comes through the Silverstone MS09, where you populate your own M.2 SATA-based SSD, and you have an elegant solution for additional storage capacity, you know, that you can take with you anywhere. It's awesome. But what if you have spare SSDs lying around that you're no longer using inside your main PC and don't want to go the route of already, like, you know, these little external drives? So Silverstone has a solution for you. And so these are the MMSO2 and MMSO1B. Wow, the name is key here. They're water resistant, shockproof, and there's a lot of military grade stuff in the marketing name. So we're gonna put this through a little torture test for the elementals, the elements, yeah. And see if the internal drive survives, because with my previous test with the Corsair Survivor USB, the actual internal NAND completely fell apart while the enclosure remained intact.
Now, I appreciate the difference between these two. So the SO1 is basically just a plastic shell with a rubber housing. So it's good for, like, you know, being rough and stuff, while the SO2 is more elegant, but it's literally just two slabs of aluminum combined together with some rubber in between. And the way you access the drives is pretty similar, but also different. So this one is rated for IP65, which means it's water resistant. You know, it'll be fine for rains and splashes and stuff like that, but don't submerge this in water. It has this rubber housing. I'm guessing it's to just prevent a little additional damage to the actual plastic housing that is underneath. And it's got a little flap that you can access for this USB port. It has a USB cable that comes separately. You have a little tool so you can actually open it up and insert the SSD inside. Now, my concern is that on the interior, the SSD is not being held by anything in particular. It basically just sits in the cavity, and we have little padding so that it does have a little bit of compression so that it doesn't, like, shake around inside. It's a good implementation because it can support 7 or 9.5 millimeter SSDs. So regardless if it's a thin drive or a thick one, it will fit inside the SO1. Now, the SO2 has the same idea for external storage, but totally different approach. So not only this thing more elegant because it's literally just an aluminum slab, but it has an IP68 water resistance, so it can withstand for 60 minutes in water up to 1.5 meters. So that's awesome in case, you know, this gets actually submerged in water. This is fresh water, by the way. It has an actual USB cable that's built into the round housing, which is type C. So that's the one difference, because the speeds on this one are USB 3.1 Gen 2 versus Gen 1 on the SO1. And so here you access the internals by unscrewing 6 screws, all of which have this rubber grommet around it to prevent any leaks. And you open it up, and inside we have the SSD cavity, which has little pegs at the bottom, so it actually kind of holds the SSD in place so it doesn't maneuver anywhere. We also get 2 foam pads that you can install depending on the thickness of the SSD, and a thermal pad that you can install because this entire aluminum enclosure can act as a heatsink. Now, the type C cable here has a little rubber tip in case it does get submerged in water. It's not completely exposed, so that's fine. And the cable is actually pretty long, so it's not, doesn't have to be, like, super close to your PC. And I like this sort of built-in implementation. You don't have to bring any additional cables. It's all in one unit. All right, it's time to torture these things.
Okay, now. I didn't want to do anything crazy with this one because it's still a plastic enclosure. We do have the rubber protection on the exterior for that additional drop protection, but it's really good for anti-fungus, anti-moisture, and anti like really sharp spikes in temperatures. So that's good. Your SSD will be protected, but in terms of like impact stuff, this is not the way to go. But I am curious to know how the aluminum enclosure is doing inside the freezer. Let's go check it out. Man, this thing is cold. Let's go see if it boots. I just hope it hasn't leaked because of all the drops. Well, looks like the good luck drive is in fact alive. Now, I was hoping for cooler temperatures because this thing just came out of the freezer and it somehow is 2 degrees Celsius hotter than my SSDs inside the enclosure. Not sure what's that about. Now, the enclosure has withstand some damage on the corners, obviously falling on concrete like that. It's also quite heavy, so that also contributes to the additional force applied on it, but just minor scuffs. The drive inside and the cable are working just fine. And so if you're looking for something that can withstand a lot of impact, this is a good option, especially because it's fully waterproof, type C, Gen 2, so the speeds are fine, and you can populate whatever capacity SSD you want inside here. While this guy, the plastic one, is also a good option, but less so for impact stuff. It's also lighter, so potentially a little bit better for travel, but this guy, not so good for travel because it's quite heavy, but it will definitely withstand anything that comes its way. All right, so that is how you create your own external 2.5-inch enclosure that is waterproof and can withstand quite a bit of damage. So let me know if you guys are interested in. All the links to purchase will be in the description below. Make sure to check out this other relevant content. Subscribe for more. Make sure to check out our new Boot Sequence channel, and we'll see you in the next one.